the announcement was made that we detected a gravity wave from a distant object that has a lot of, had a very big or catastrophic gravity event millions of years ago, and the gravity wave showed up here. Now, gravity wave, obviously, how hard could it be? So when we do experiments on light to detect particles, we detect particles of light. When we do experiments on light to detect waves, we detect waves of light. When we look at forces, that's the transmission of, or the a force over a distance is the transmission of energy. So we can find energy traveling in waves, we can try and find energy traveling in packets or particles. So people have speculated since, well, this is the 100th anniversary of Einstein's publishing his landmark papers. People have speculated on the nature of gravity. Now understand, we understand gravity in extraordinary, with extraordinary precision. We land spacecraft on Mars, precisely. Everybody watching this has probably used a global positioning system on his or her phone or in a car or in an airplane that's navigating with global positioning. Those satellites that enable this system to work rely on both special relativity, which is the influence of the speed of the spacecraft relative to the airplane or ground, and general relativity, which is the speed of time as affected by the Earth's gravity. So people have suspected or speculated that there will be waves of gravity. And waves of gravity would date back to the Big Bang, to the origin of the universe, 13.7 billion years ago. But they're very weak, extraordinarily weak. Compare how easy it is to use chemical energy to hold a ball up against the pull of gravity, or to hold yourself upright against the pull of gravity. Gravity, of the forces of nature, is the weakest one. And so if its energy or force or influence moves at the speed of light, like everything else does, does it move in waves? Well, to detect them, you need an extraordinarily sensitive instrument. Crazy sensitive, because this influence is so weak. And we did it. We set up instrument in Louisiana and in Washington State using these mirrors. And as the gravity wave passed through the Earth, the mirrors moved just. And with extraordinarily sensitive measurement of the waves of reflected laser light, we were able to detect this small movement, these small movements. And so what does that mean for us? Well, I don't know. But the discovery of relativity led to global positioning systems and the internet and our ability to plant crops with precision and feed 7.3 billion people where we used to only feed 1.5 billion people. So who knows where this discovery will lead? But I wouldn't be surprised if it leads to a new understanding of another aspect of physics and a new source of energy, or we prove to ourselves that there is no other source of energy and we got to rely on wind and solar or what have you. Who knows what it will lead to? But the basic research is worth celebrating. This is a society that uses its intellect and treasure to make discoveries about nature and ultimately where we all fit into the cosmos, our place in space. So if you're a human able to hear this broadcast or watch this broadcast, celebrate it. Humans have made another discovery about the universe. It's not bad.